Now let us see accessing a variable through its pointer. Accessing a variable means how we are going to make use of the value of a variable through its pointer variable. Look at this example. Here quantity and n are integers and p is a pointer variable. The star represents, at the point of declaration, the star represents p is a pointer variable to the compiler. And we are initializing quantity as 179. And we are collecting the address of quantity using address operator. Now I want to copy the value, quantity is 179. I want to copy this value to n. Just copying of value of, this can be easily done by n equal to quantity. So automatically this quantity will be copied to n. But we want to copy this quantity 179 using the pointer variable because the address of quantity is stored in p. How we can access the value of quantity by its address? That can be done by the operator called as dereferencing operator, otherwise indirection operator, which is nothing but once again an asterisk. You should not get confused with these two asterisk, both of them are asterisk actually. At the point of declaration, it informs, this asterisk informs the compiler that p is a pointer variable. But when we process this one, whenever there is a star in front of p other than declaration point, this will be called as dereferencing operator. And what will the compiler do when it is, when it executes star p not in the, execute star p other than the declaration part, whenever the star p is not in declaration part, it will be represented as a dereferencing operator and it will be executed in the way directly the compiler goes to p. P contains address of variable quantity, it collects the address and the star represents dereferencing, that is it going back to the address. If this star indicates, otherwise informs the compiler to move back to this, ask to collect the address from p and move back to the address, and in that address it collects the value and that value will be stored in n. So this star p gets the value 179 and assigned to n. Now n will be having 179. This is called as accessing of variable through the pointer. And this statement can also be p equal to ampersand quantity collects the address of quantity in p, and star p, n assigned with the star p, collects the value of quantity and it stores in n. These two statements can be written in as a single statement as n equal to star ampersand quantity. This address operator collects the address of quantity. This dereferencing operator goes to the, go back to the address and collects the value and stores in n. So these two can be done in a single statement using ampersand as well as asterisk. Let us see an example to access a value of a variable using the pointer variable. This program, in this program we have declared x and y as integer variable and ptr as a pointer variable which belongs to the data type int. So it can collect only address of an integer variable. Now we are assigning x is equal to 10, ptr equal to ampersand x. So this pointer variable collects the address of x. Suppose address of x is 4104. That address will be stored in ptr. Coming to next statement, y equal to star ptr. This is not a declaration statement. So this star is a dereferencing operator. What's the property of dereferencing operator? It goes to ptr, collects the address stored in ptr and it moves back to that particular address and collects the value. This is the duty of star. So as soon as this statement is encountered, directly goes to ptr, collects the address 4104 and goes to that address and get the value, and that value will be stored in Y. So now Y contains the value 10. Now let us see what will be printed. The address of X, Y, everything. Print of value of X is percentage D. What is percentage D? X. What is X? 10. So value of X is 10. So your output will be value of X is 10. Next, second print of statement. Percentage D. What is percentage D? X. What is X? 10. 10 is stored at, this is unsigned integer, ampersand X. Ampersand X is address. So this statement gives me address of X. So what will be printed? 10 is stored at, what is address of X? 4104. Next, third print of statement. Ampersand percentage D. What is percentage D? Star and. This address operator collects the address of X, and this dereferencing operator collects the value in that particular address. What is address of X? 4104. And it goes and collects the value 10. So what will be printed in this place? Value of 10 will be printed in this place. So 10 is stored at, what is percentage U? Unsigned integer, ampersand X. So address of X. So 10 is stored in, address of X is 4104. So we have finished third print of, fourth print of, percentage D is stored. Once again, percentage D. Star PTR. What is PTR? It contains 4104. What is star PTR? It goes to the address of 4104 and collects the value. So in this place, 10 will be printed. 10 is stored at percentage U. What is PTR? PTR value. What is PTR value? 4104. So 10 is stored at 4104. All of them are same statements, but the different way of printing the values and their address. Now, print of percentage D. What is percentage D? PTR. PTR means without any ampersand or indirection operator. So it collects the value stored in PTR. So 4104 is stored at here address. What is address of PTR? 4106. 4104 is stored at 4106. Next, print of percentage D, Y. What is Y? Value of Y is 10. So 10 is stored at address of Y. What is address of Y? 4108. So 10 is stored at 4108. Star PTR equal to 25. Star PTR. What is the meaning of star PTR? Value of star PTR means it collects the address. Star represents dereferencing operator. So it goes to the address and collects the value. Actually, it goes to that particular address. Here we are doing initialization. Star PTR equal to 25. So it collects the address and goes to that place and initialize that value to be 25. Now the value of X is 25. Now X equal to ampersand percentage D. What is percentage D? Value of X 25. So now X equal to 25. So I can change the value of X without using X. That is the more important point to be notified in this example. Here I haven't used any, I haven't represented X. I have just used the address and I have changed X. This process is more effective in functions whenever we want to return more number of values. Whenever we use pointers, and using that pointers, if we change the values, currently the changes will take place in that particular address. So everything will be transferred to the original main function also. So the changed value can also be accessed from main function, whatever that has been happened in the function, called function. So without using the variable, I can change the value of the variable. I can access the value of the variable using pointer variable.